Breakfast. Longanisa with some fried egg, delicious avocado, and some tomatoes. These three, all from Kauai. Today I've got a hike to go on, a really fun one. I've been on it before. I want to show my sister. Last time we went just to the private beach area. On this trip, we're going to go all the way to the waterfall, which is pretty epic. I love waterfalls and I can't wait to swim in the little lagoon underneath. Just uploaded a video on Benjamin TV, a Coffee Monday segment that I did with Rainbow Joe's. Today's video is on cold brew coffee, which is my favorite. Right now it's my favorite. Maybe Judy, you could put the link down below.
It's my sister's family's last meal. So sad. So sad. Stay longer. Because Eli's vacation's for another week.
I know.
Yeah. Eli should stay with Mama.
I know.
He's on his vacation.
Enjoying the morning view. At least K-Bear is.
Mia.
Oh no, that's Mia.
Yeah, Mia and K-Bear.
Oh my gosh, she's so cute.
A book of colors? You get to read that to your sisters. What color is that?
Red.
Red. What color is this?
Earth.
Orange.
Ew. Gross.
Is that gross?
Here we go. We are on our way up this mountain, which borders the water. So it's got some great scenes. It's a 2-mile hike to the beach. It's not a beginner hike, but a beginner could make it. It just takes a while. Got my Vibrams on. As you can see, it's not only really rocky and tons of roots, but because it rains a lot, it's fairly muddy. I'm already breathing heavily.
Apparently, this Kona coffee is 5 times stronger than regular coffee. And is it stronger because it's in ice cream form or what?
It's just because
amount of caffeine.
Once they put the milk in and everything like that, they put it straight black.
Oh.
Straight black coffee. Milk and everything, it dilutes it.
That is good.
Hopefully this will wake me up. Alternative for coffee.
We were gonna have this last night and then.
This was open now, I can bring like a whole pint.
Yeah.
Oh my god!
Timeout. Come on, walk to timeout. Over here. Over here. Right there.
Mama.
Oh, what is that phone? Yeah, that's Mama's phone.
Mama phone.
Beautiful. Yep, straight down. Oh man, it's beautiful like that. It's the very first view, everybody. Woo! Kind of scary.
Where are you going, Key Bear? I thought you were going night night.
Baby. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, mommy. Hi, mommy.
Half the family's gone. So sad. I was hoping my sister could stay, but you know, people got work. Hey, careful. Hey, get off your sister. So later today we're gonna meet up with Benji. They're hiking around a retreat area we were at last year. We visited during the Rob Rob retreat. Beautiful property, huge. And I believe it was built for the youth. No.
Oh, she's sleepy?
Yeah, she's snoring. She's still sleeping. Close your eyes. Close your eyes.
My heart's pounding already. Probably, say a quarter mile up. Surprised there's people with full backpacks. That lady before, seniors on this trip. Hey, you guys want to take a break? Huh?
Down.
You know how to get down. Go down. There you go. There you go.
No, no, no.
Go ahead. You're almost on the floor. There you go. Come on. Yay. See? Hi.
This is how you sweep the roads in Hawaii.
That coconut leaves. We're gonna use that as a...
You make a broom?
Yeah, balista thing.
Oh, cool. Here at Ono Shaved Ice. This is where one of our friends told us to go. Chanel, hi. She said they have the best halo halo shaved ice here. I don't know, what else is good here?
Hawaii sunrise is the best shaved ice.
Ooh, then I'll try that as well.
Was that leche flan?
Yeah.
Ooh. Dad, where are you? Oh, here he is. Okay, I'll just give it to Mom.
Mommy.
You share with Jay Bizzle.
Ice cream.
Flowers. I thought mine would be the size of my parents' holo holo. There's no way I could eat this on my own. Try it. What'd you think of it, Dad?
It is very good. We're planning to move here.
What?
We're planning to move here from Washington.
Okay.
It was just too much. We got brain freeze.
More than halfway to the beach.
Lighthouse, but it's closed today. Out of all the days, it's closed on Monday.
Lighthouse.
It's right there. You see it?
Trail is totally different now. It's like a red clay consistency here. We can see the water. The beach is still right around that corner, but man, is it beautiful here. Yes. Last time I came here, I didn't have a backpack. I don't even know. I think I did wear a shirt. I wore a long sleeve shirt, but I didn't have anything, no water. Because I knew it was going to be a pretty grueling hike, and somebody else offered their water as long as they carry their backpack when they get tired. But yeah, you know, this. If you guys are here in Kauai and you're going to do this hike, it's Kalalau hike. It's like the most northern beach that you have access to with a road, but it still takes 2 mile hike to get there. Pack light, but make sure you pack water. I would suggest drinking as much water beforehand and then just packing enough water for your trip rather than, you know, adding too much weight to yourself. But
does that lighthouse still work, Dad? What's the history of the lighthouse?
It was built in 1909.
Oh.
To guide the ships. But in 1979, they stopped the operation because it's expensive, so they put a modern way of warning the ship.
Juliana's going to show me the baby bird. Gentle to the baby bird. These geese are getting a little too friendly. Just hanging out here, relaxing, hanging out with birds, geese, baby birds.
Hoy!
That was totally Filipino.
Not feeling too good. I think all the sugar from that snow cone or shaved ice got to me. Cause it makes me get dizzy. Anyway, so we're killing time right now because we're gonna meet up with Benji. But I don't know. I thought we were supposed to meet up at 1, but my parents say 3 o'clock, and they're not answering their phone. So I have a feeling they're like at the beach right now.
We finally made it to the entrance of the beach, which is right next to this little stream that goes all the way to the Pacific. Believe it or not, this is a white sandy beach that me and the Rob Ross hung out on last time, and we had lunch and just hung out.
This is an awesome tree.
people have been writing their names on it. Oh, that one says 2013. May 2012. This is a national park. It's okay, come on. You're waiting for a monkey to appear.
Har, 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 har.
What?
Har, har, har.
What?
Har. Oh. Har.
Leaf. Leaf, yeah.
What? Leaf? Leaf, leaf.
More leaves.
Finally made it. Oh yeah. It's beautiful. Totally worth it. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna go swimming over there.
There's signs that says keep out. And I'm pretty sure I just heard a coconut fall from the tree. And it sounded heavy and loud and dangerous. Did you hear the coconut? No? Over there. Did you hear it? That's why the fruit are falling. Let's go back to the car.
No!
Where do you want to go? Well, let's go back. Come on.
No! No!
Bye.
No, no, no!
It's pretty here.
Let's go.
She's gonna hold her sister. Wow, bait naman. That's a good ate. You're such a good ate.
No, that's no, baby don't. Toy. That's baby toy. Thank you, Ate Juliana. Good girl, you're so good. You're so nice.
You happy now? Happy? Are you happy now?
Is it locked? Oh my gosh, it looks like an owl. It's like an owl butterfly.
Sometime between 3 and 3:30 island time, smiley face.
What does that mean, like 4 o'clock?
He basically meant Filipino time, but...
We could just walk around here.
Oh, yeah, you guys can walk around.
Ooh, Juliana, come on, look at the giant rocks.
I wouldn't...
Yeah, yeah, no, oh. Yeah.
I want to take a... Okay.
Yeah, no.
Okay, JB.
Oh, JB.
Look over here, say cheese.
JB.
Look up. Now this is something else. I can't even express the feeling I have right now. Even though there's no ocean view or anything, this is amazing.
I just wonder if you can fit us the guavas.
I'm at a property called Makanalani, and it's like a retreat center for youth. The owner, Eric, he and I believe his family or a group of people that he does this with, provide this space for youth. So he's gonna come here and meet us, but for now we're just enjoying the view here, and there's way more to see. Juliana, oh yeah, they're just walking right now.
Look like it's gonna rain.
Oh, it is raining. Uh-oh.
Let's go back, Juliana.
Yeah, it's raining. I was going for her to go back all the way down, but you know how the rain is here. Once it rains, it literally pours. I don't think Juliana remembers this place. Do you remember this place, JB? You were just a baby.
Yeah.
Back patio area. Look at this amazing table. I talked about that last time. It started raining, so this is a very unique view that we didn't get to see last time. It's kind of peaceful with the rain sound. Look at this. This is like something out of Jurassic Park, but like the actual park, not the disaster dinosaur attacking version. This is like what it probably would have looked like if there was dinosaurs just calmly roaming around, not killing people. Dad, what do you think about this?
Beautiful.
Isn't this beautiful?
This is the most beautiful place I've ever been.
Dad, see this piece of wood?
Yeah, well.
This is, I believe, one piece of wood, or two maybe. Oh yeah, two pieces it looks like.
So they're joined together. But what kind of wood is
it? Wow! This is Kauai rain for you guys. I have to show you over here so you guys understand. Look at all that water. So that's like, look at that. That's water from the roof. That's pretty awesome. Look at this. It's like her dance floor. Is this your own personal dance floor right now? It's like dancing with the YouTube star right here. Whoa, are you dancing? I would like to say we brought the rain from Seattle, but this rain, something else. We don't really get this so often. And it does this regularly here. Last year, the reason I came to Kauai was because of this property. The Rob Ross had a retreat here. And if you guys don't know, I mentioned last year, this is a place for youth that don't get to experience things like this. It's already amazing in itself, but to bring youth here and get to experience the wildlife. Eric, could you tell us about what you guys do here and why it's so special?
We bought this property, number one, for the youth. We bought it so that we could bring kids here. You could call them underprivileged, but they're not underprivileged in all respects. But they're kids who can't come to a camp. We bought that for that purpose, and we don't ever, ever, ever charge anything for the camps. The kids always come for free. The property is 130 acres. It's a farm. We farm sheep. We farm milk cows. We have mini donkeys. They like donkeys out of the Shrek movie.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
real,
yeah.
Little short guys, short tubby. The kids love them, and they love the kids. And then we built this facility that can house 30 at a time. And we're expanding it ever so slightly, but we built it very, very upscale. We were going to build it for like 100, 150 kids, and we were told we cannot, but it's too many kids. So we built it smaller, but we built it in a way that wows the kids. Oh, they are just, their socks are blown off when they come.
Yeah, you know, I'm in real estate. That's my profession, and I see a lot of amazing houses. I've never been in, I call this a home, so grand. And it's amazing that it's for youth, you know, for kids. I used to work with kids at the YMCA, so I have a passion for working with youth. And I agree, you know, a lot of these kids, they would say underprivileged. But, you know, you see the joy they have, right, without this.
Absolutely.
So when they come here, this is just adding to the joy they have. Because maybe their simple, more simple life allows them to appreciate things. So
totally, and actually we found that the kids from like the public housing, from the quote disadvantaged areas, they are so well behaved and appreciative, exactly the opposite of what we've led to believe. And they walk in here and they feel special, and that's what they're meant to feel. They feel super special, like they're being treated special, and that's what they are.
Eric was nice enough to offer me another visit with Juliana to visit some of the animals. I'm hoping to get a couple starfruit. I've been dreaming about your starfruit. It's the best starfruit I've ever had. But last year we asked for donations, and you guys, a lot of you were kind enough to donate. We had a few hundred donations, and we would love to ask again for anybody who has room in their heart to give to something really good. And this is a great place. You know, I get a good positive energy. I will start the donations off. I'll put the link down below. So if you feel like this would be a deserving place for your generosity, please check out the link. And I'll show you guys more, you know, like either whether it's today or later when I come back with Juliana. So Eric, thank you so much for having us.
Thank you very much. It's always great to have you guys here.
One thing I didn't get to do last time I was here was kind of explore the property, especially look at their abundance of edibles.
Yeah, you can see
breadfruit, what we had the other day. Let's look. Let's see. Oh yeah, look, you can see one right there. I'm zooming up on it right now. This is the breadfruit that we were so curious about last time.
It's a little bit young.
Yeah, it is a little young, but it's okay. You know what? We'll still try it.
Yeah.
Look, it's just dripping with something. I don't know what that is. That's so cool. Yeah, look at these. These are good to go.
Yeah.
Look at this. Oh, that, you know what? That one's ready.
Yeah, this is a junk tree, so I'm just gonna get
it. I love star fruit. Look at this.
Wow.
Look at how many are growing.
You want me
on
to take out the big
tree.
One?
Yeah, the They're big just one. Growing everywhere. Yeah. I mean, if you had a ladder, you could be picking all day long.
Pretty much. We just send the kids. That's all we do. We don't take it to market. Inside the property, we've got...
Is this edible right here?
So yes, absolutely.
Juliana.
This is all for the kids. Yeah. When the kids
so
come,
this,
we, send them
we
out
just yeah. picked it. Juliana, eat. Eat.
Yeah.
Can I have some?
Yeah,
Can I put it up to my mouth.
Some guava on the way.
That's so good.
Fresh from
Don't
the
be shy. You know you want some of that. She just ate a whole starfruit on her own on the way here. The way.
Oh wow!
There you go. That it doesn't get better than that little one.
Off the.
Look at all these guavas on the ground. Oh wow, look at this. I already know mom's in heaven right now. Look at this beautiful guava tree. In fact, I'm gonna just go on and pick this. Oh. Huh? Would you like that?
Yeah.
Here, let's. How do you eat a guava, Dad?
Just like that.
You just eat it? You can eat the skin?
No, I eat it without with the skin.
Here, you want to
eat the skin?
Yeah.
This one's good. What I would want to see if somebody's, if a little fly got it.
Go ahead. Try it.
Take this part off. And I'm done. Ready to eat.
Mm.
Yep. Oh man.
But this kind, we're heading back home. Oh my gosh, my parents were so excited to see all the fruits and to be able to pick it straight from the tree. That was pretty awesome. Oh, I don't even know what's back. Whoa, star fruit galore. That was awesome. And the property is so beautiful. I didn't realize last year when I went how large that property is. And their mission is, man, they're just such great people. All the girls are pretty exhausted. I predict a very long nap for all three of them. I'm gonna take like a nice hot shower. Like you're flying, we're so high. Oh my gosh, I'm like, this is kind of scary. Good job at the Juliana.
Nummy. Dance, 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 dance. Dance, dance, and dance, then dance. Dance, 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 dance. That's more like running. Dance, dance, and dance, then dance, dance, dance. Dance, dance, dance. Whoa!